before it gets over 100 this afternoon. All right, the airline industry is suffering from a worldwide pilot shortage. And with the right training and certification, young pilots have a chance at big paychecks. One place that specializes in this kind of training right here in Sacramento. This morning, Gary's on the go, the Wild Blue Yonder, at the Advanced International Aviation Academy at the Sacramento Executive Airport. All right, Captain Gary, where are you taking us today?
All right, well, let's see. I don't exactly know where. I don't have my coordinates, so I don't really know exactly where we're going. But this man certainly does, Captain Augustine Joseph. Good to see you again. It's been about a year or so since I saw you. How are things going? Good?
Fantastic, fantastic. Things are going fantastic. We are growing. The businesses and the school and everything is growing. Life is good.
Life is good. All right, Advanced International Aviation Academy. Come on down. This guy teaches you to be pilots. He's been a pilot for pretty much ever. And look what you did. Last time I was here, this thing was in pieces, and then you put it together. So let everybody know what this thing is. It's amazing and gorgeous looking.
So this airplane is a military fighter trainer, originally designed and built in Russia, another form of it, and then it was in China, and it was built for military pilot training for many, many years. Almost 20 different countries have used this plane for their training fleet for fighter pilots.
You train the fighter pilots in this thing. Wow.
It's called the CJ-6.
Okay, the CJ-6. There you go. So this is what the... How long did it take you to put this thing together?
It took me close to 4 years because it came in pieces in a container.
Oh, my God.
From almost like a scrapyard from the military.
And then he has it. He's ready to put it together. All right. So tell us what that first flight was all about. I think we've got some video. It was pretty amazing because that's got to take some guts. And I know you have the guts. You built it. You're ready to go. You got the engineers ready to go. And then you took this thing up. What was it like?
So it's not like building a car or anything. It has to be all done with manuals and precise processes. And then after we finish building, and it takes a long time.
Yeah.
Especially the parts, finding parts and everything. It's not very easy because it's a very old plane, and also, you know, it's all metric system. And then the FAA will come and inspect all the work. It's not like they let you fly it without inspection. So the FAA will come and inspect every work that you've done, whether you've done it right. And after that, they'll allow you to do some testing.
Yeah.
And that process is when you first take it out flying. It's very exciting.
Yeah, we're seeing the video.
It's flown for so many decades, and then the airplane is coming alive again.
What did it feel like?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it was exciting.
Right. Yeah. That's what this guy does. So he's like, let's get this thing up in the air. Now you showed me some video. I don't know. I can't see the video that we have now, but you showed me some video of you taking this thing up for the first time also, and then actually rolling it.
Yeah.
Are you crazy?
We have to do all the testing for controls, response to the controls.
Right.
We have to check the rigging of the controls. We have to check the G loads on the plane, what it can sustain according to the manuals.
Right.
So, in stages, the test is taken, you know, small tests, bigger tests, checking the emergency systems. All of those things are done before you prove that the airplane is fully airworthy.
Yeah, wow. So you go up there and you have to test the G's. So in order to test the G's, you got to get this going and get that going. But you're testing. What if something goes wrong? I saw you earlier. You got a parachute on your back, don't you?
Yes. Yes, I love that parachute. You got to have that parachute when you do these kind of flying. Because if anything goes wrong, you at least have an out.
You at least have an out. Okay. Yeah. All right. Unfortunately, we're out of time now. But in the 9 o'clock hour, I'm going to get inside that thing. The first thing I saw the canopy. I was like, does the canopy go like back? Can we just sit in with the canopy open? Because I'm a little claustrophobic now, Richard. And he said, yeah. So we'll get in it. We'll fire it up. I hear it super, super loud, but that'll be a lot of fun coming to the night. Captain, thank you so much for inviting us out. Look how beautiful that is. I mean, come on, right?
I mean, it's a great plane, and put that together, it's amazing how much work goes in to rehabbing a plane. And it looks gorgeous, the paint job and everything. Gary, thank you. All right, 8:31 right now.